Okay, you can rest, sit.
The 26th of August, the Bourbon Argos, one of MSF's search and rescue ships, has on board 800 people rescued in two operations in just one day. They're from Syria, Côte d'Ivoire, or Mali.
I'm very relieved and happy. It all went well. Everyone seemed to be okay, just exhausted and dehydrated. Extraordinary.
In a little over 3 months, MSF teams have rescued 11,482 people, mainly off the coast of Libya. At the beginning of August, this Syrian couple and their little girl survived the sinking of their makeshift boat.
I lifted her up and shook her to make her bring up the water she had swallowed. I can swim, but she can't.
200,000 of the 300,000 people who have already crossed the Mediterranean Sea this year have landed in Greece. European regulations stipulate migrants must be registered in the first country in the Union they enter. But there is no system in Greece to deal with such large numbers of migrants and refugees.
This system is not good. You already stay here 7 days. My friend is 20 days stay here. No food, no water, no others.
There are several thousand refugees on the island of Kos. As there are no reception facilities, they live out in the open, with no protection from the blazing sun. Some are directed by officials to a stadium where there's no drinking water or sanitation. At one of the sites where migrants have set up their own refuge, MSF teams distribute basic necessities and provide medical consultations.
We are really focused on the mobile street clinic, which we usually see more vulnerable groups, like pregnant women, infants, children, and handicapped patients. Mostly what we see is respiratory tract infection, traumatology while those people are sleeping in the streets due to the traveling conditions, skin diseases, and common cold, mostly to babies, because they are more sensitive in the weather condition and sleeping outside.
As there's nothing for them here, many migrants opt to continue their way across Europe. From Greece, they have to pass through Macedonia. On the 20th and 21st of August, Macedonian troops fired tear gas and stun grenades to disperse thousands of refugees trying to cross over the Greek border. An MSF medical team treated 110 casualties in just 2 days. The Macedonian authorities finally allowed them through, enabling the refugees to continue their journey until they encounter the next hurdle.